Good afternoon, students. Today we are going to learn the last chapter of the subject, chapter number 18, Management of the Welfare State of Swaraj. Shivaji Maharaj struggled long against many unjust powers. They were the Adil Shahi and Mughal powers, the Portuguese and the Siddhis of Janjira. That is how an independent Hindavi Swaraj was created. Now Shivaji Maharaj, in his whole life, he fought with the with Adil Shah, with the Mughal powers, the Portuguese, Siddhis, with everyone he fought. That is how he created his own independent Hindavi Swaraj. For smooth working, Shivaji Maharaj divided the administration into 8 departments. So for the smooth working of the Swaraj, he divided the administration. Administration means managing duties, responsibilities and the rules. So whatever the duties, the responsibilities or whatever the rules and regulations were there, he divided into 8 departments. He appointed a minister in charge of each. This was his famous council of 8 ministers. Now, for that, he also appointed one minister who will all coordinate the things, who will manage the things. And the Swaraj of Shivaji Maharaj was a state run for the welfare of the people in the true sense of the term. It was run with the assistance of the 8 ministers. Now the Swaraj, it was the administration, whatever the duties, responsibilities were there, it was divided among 8 departments. And each 8 department had one minister who was in charge of it. And it was run with the help of these 8 ministers. Shivaji Maharaj himself made the appointments of these 8 ministers and other important officers on the basis of their eligibility and merit. He supervised all their work. Now Shivaji Maharaj he appointed these 8 ministers who would look upon the duties or regulations, rules and regulations, responsibilities of the Swaraj on the basis of their capacity and capability, who is good enough to manage all these things. And he supervised, Shivaji Maharaj only supervised all their works. Do you know? Food, clothing and shelter are the basic necessities of life. In a welfare state, these needs of people are satisfied. Women are honored. Common people, peasants are not deceived. Injustice is not done to anyone. Justice is dispensed quickly. Agriculture and industries develop well. Folk arts flourish. People can live a happy, contented life. Now we all know that food, clothing, shelter are the basic need of each and every one. And in the in a welfare settlements where people are given more importance, so their needs, whatever people's needs are there, that was satisfied. And women were honored, they were not disrespected, they were honored. And whenever any need arises, when injustice happens, justice was given to them. And then agriculture and industries were developed so that people could earn their living and live a happy life. Okay, people lived happily in the Swaraj created by Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. Therefore, the qualities of confidence, self-respect and patriotism. Now in this picture you can see protection of environment, where the 2 men are cutting the trees and Shivaji Maharaj is stopping them. He is explaining to them that what they did is very wrong, and these 2 men are ashamed of their behavior. World Environment Day is celebrated every year on 5th June to emphasize the importance of conserving and protecting the environment. Okay. So World Environment Day, we celebrate each and every year on the month of June 5th. Water management. Shivaji Maharaj had various bunds built near the villages in Swaraj to make drinking water available to the people. Canals were dug out to make water available for agriculture. Due to this, there was an increase in the produce. Now, Shivaji Maharaj, he made drinking water available to the people. He made canals wherever possible so that they could use for the agriculture. In this way, the produce of fruits and vegetables were more. People in Swaraj never felt the severity of droughts. Droughts means where there is a shortage of water. During the regime of Shivaji Maharaj, the number of people living on forts was quite large. That time in Shivaji Maharaj's fort, there were quite a large amount of people staying. So Shivaji Maharaj took care to make proper arrangements for water on the forts. So many food and water, everything was needed. And Shivaji Maharaj, he took proper care so that each and everyone would get sufficient food and water. Before building a fort, the place was inspected to see whether enough water was available there. In case it did not have water, tanks and reservoirs were built there before the onset of the rainy season, and rainwater was stored in them. So before building a fort, first they used to inspect whether they have enough water available in that area. If not, they used to build tanks and reservoirs, and also they used to collect the rainwater on the rainy season, so they had enough water. The stored water was used economically. Due to such water management, people on the forts and other subjects in Swaraj did not suffer from shortage of water even during drought periods. Now, they did not had any shortage of water. Whatever water they stored, they used it very nicely. Shivaji Maharaj took care of that very properly. In this way, there the people did not suffer from the shortage of water. Now in this picture you can see Shivaji Maharaj made arrangements for drinking water and irrigation by constructing bunds and canals. Okay, you can see in this picture. Now we will see drought relief. Shivaji Maharaj gave various facilities to drought affected peasants. He used to waive taxes, so the severity of drought was reduced to people in Swaraj. In a drought year, Shivaji Maharaj distributed the grain stored in the state granaries free of cost to the people. Now he used, when a drought arises in a year, Shivaji Maharaj, whatever grains he used to store, he used to give them to the people free of cost. He also undertook repairs of various forts and construction of dams, bunds and canals during drought years. This way, peasants and artisans or baladedars could earn their daily living and did not feel the severity of drought. As the peasant became wealthy, he could afford to buy things like footwear, clothes, etc. This provided work to the artisans. Those who were homeless till then developed the capacity to build their own houses. This in turn provided work to the masons, the carpenters, the blacksmiths, the brickmakers. This is how, along with the peasants in Swaraj, artisans also became happy and wealthy. Now, when the peasants mean the farmers, when they became wealthy, they were able to afford, they could buy things like footwear, clothes. And while buying this footwear and clothes, what this provided work to other people as well. And those who did not have home, they started making house on their own. In this way, the carpenters, the brickmakers started working, and this is how they came in. So they were all happy and wealthy in the Swaraj. Now we'll see seed trade and other markets. Shivaji Maharaj raised his own independent navy in order to protect his Swaraj well and to establish his rule over the sea adjoining Swaraj. But that was not all. He also had special cargo ships. built to promote trade in Swaraj. He developed trade paths like Rajapur. He built a special market on Raigad. He started a separate marketplace at Khet Shivapur near Pune. He developed marketplaces in big towns and roadside villages. A new path or settlement was established at Pasha near Pune by the orders of Veeramata Jijabai. It was referred to as Jijapur. Now Shivaji Maharaj started a independent navy, so not only protect his kingdom but also to do the trade work where he can buy and sell goods from other countries also. He even built a special market on Raigad area and a separate marketplace at Khet Shivapur, which is near to Pune. Now he developed marketplaces in big towns and roadside villages also. And a new settlement was established at Pasha near Pune. And this was the order of Veeramata Jijabai. So this place was given the name Jijapur. Shivaji Maharaj levied more taxes on goods imported from the outside regions to promote trade within Swaraj. So he used to put more taxes on the goods which he used to import from the outside countries. Okay, he levied more tax on the salt produced in the Portuguese territory, which it made it costlier. On the other hand, he reduced the tax on the salt produced in Swaraj so that people could buy it at a cheaper rate. So whatever the salt he used to produced in the Swaraj, he made it at a cheaper rate so that many people could afford to buy it. Naturally, it led to an increase in the trade of salt produced in Swaraj. Thus, local trade was encouraged. So this made an increase in the purchase of salt from the Swaraj area. Shivaji Maharaj made efforts for the growth of trade and industries in Swaraj. He personally made sure that his subjects would not be cheated by the merchants in any way. When he came to know that people have been cheated in the coconut and betel nut trade in Konkan, he warned the subedar of that region. So Shivaji Maharaj, he personally used to see whether the people are getting cheated or not. If so, he would warn the subedars of that region. And if the second time, they won't cheat the people, the normal people. High regard for women. Shivaji Maharaj had ordered that the women and children in the enemy camp were not to be harmed in any way during the period of war. So while going to the war, Shivaji Maharaj, he used to warn his own people that you should not harm any woman or any children. They should be respected and they should be taken well care. In fact, they were to be treated with great respect. The behavior of Shivaji Maharaj on several occasions set the ideal of how women were to be treated. The Maratha army had marched upon Belewadi in Karnataka to vanquish the fortress there. Malama Desai, a brave woman, fought a great battle in defense of the fortress. When Shivaji Maharaj came to know about her courage, he called her his younger sister, returned her fortress and villages to her with honor, and gave her the title Savitri. So there was a fortress, Malama Desai, a brave woman who fought a great battle. And when Shivaji Maharaj came to know about her courage, he called her his younger sister, and he also rewarded her and he gave her the title as Savitri.